Hello everyone, in the last video we have studied that to find out the moment of inertia of a body easily we have two theorems. The first one is the theorem of perpendicular axis and the second one is the theorem of parallel axis. In the last video we have already studied the theorem of perpendicular axis. So today we will study the theorem of parallel axis. According to this theorem, the moment of inertia of a body about a given axis is equal to the sum of the moments of inertia of the body about a parallel axis through its center of mass and the product of its mass with the square of the distance between the two axes. And this theorem is true for both a plane lamina and for a three-dimensional body, unlike the theorem of perpendicular axis, which has different definitions in the plane lamina and a three-dimensional body. So today, as we are studying the theorem of parallel axis, according to this theorem, if IO is the moment of inertia of the body about a given axis, that is the moment of inertia which we have to find out, and IZ is the moment of inertia about a parallel axis passing through its center of mass, then this theorem says that IO will be equal to IG plus MH square, where M is the mass of the body and H is the distance between the two axes. Now we will prove this theorem. For proof, let us consider a plane laminar body as the first case. Let us consider a plane laminar body when the axis of rotation is in the plane of lamina. Let us consider a plane lamina like this and let AB be an axis passing through its center of mass, that is point G, and let CD be any other axis parallel to this AB axis at a distance H from this AB axis. Now let the lamina be divided into elementary particles of masses M1, M2, M3 and so on. We have divided this lamina into these elementary particles to find out the moment of inertia about AB axis and CD axis. Now, first of all, consider a particle of mass M1 at a point P, that is at a distance x1 from this AB axis, that is passing through its center of mass point Z. Now, the moment of inertia of this particle about this AB axis will be equal to the mass of the particle, that is M1, into square of the distance from the axis, that is x1 square. Therefore, the moment of inertia of M1 about AB axis is equal to M1 x1 square. In the same way, this point is at a distance of x1 from AB axis and AB axis is at a distance of h from this CD axis. Therefore, this point M1 is at a distance of h plus x1 from this CD axis. Therefore, if we have to calculate its moment of inertia about this CD axis, then that will be equal to the mass M1 into square of the distance, that is h plus x1. That is, the moment of inertia of this mass M1 about CD axis is equal to M1 into x1 plus h square. Now, we have to find out the moment of inertia of this whole lamina about these two axes. First of all, we will calculate the moment of inertia of this lamina about this AB axis. Now, that will be equal to, taking reference from this moment of inertia, that will be equal to m1 x1 square for the first particle plus m2 x2 square for the second particle. Similarly, m3 x3 square for the third particle and so on. We can write this thing in the form of a summation mx square. Now, this is the moment of inertia of the whole lamina about AB axis, that is IAB, or we can write it as IG, because this AB axis is passing through its center of mass point Z. Now, we will calculate the moment of inertia of the same lamina about axis CD with the help of this small moment of inertia. So taking reference from this moment of inertia, we can write the moment of inertia of the lamina about CD axis is equal to ICD is equal to M1 X1 plus H whole square for the first particle plus M2 X2 plus H whole square for the second particle and so on. And we can write this thing in the form of the summation like summation M into X plus H whole square. Now opening this square, we get the value x plus h whole square is equal to x square plus h square plus 2xh. Opening the summation, we get three different terms in this form, that summation m x square plus summation m h square. Taking h square outside the summation, we can write it as h square summation m plus 2hx m, that is summation m x h. Taking h outside this summation, we can write it like this. Now this summation m is the total mass of all the particles, which will be equal to the total mass of the body, that is capital M. Also we have taken here h square and h outside the summation because h is a constant term here. It does not vary with the different particles. Now this summation mx square is here equal to iz. Putting the value here, we get icd is equal to iz plus mh square plus 2h summation mx. Now this term has to be equal to 0. Why? Because since the body balances about the center of mass g, therefore the algebraic sum of all the moments about g is equal to 0. That is, summation mx is equal to 0. It means that although it is possible that different mx are not equal to 0, but after summation their algebraic sum has to be equal to 0 if the body balances about its center of mass. Putting this value in the above equation, we get ICD is equal to IG plus MH square. Hence, this is a theorem of parallel axis. Now, here we have taken a case when the axes of rotation are in the plane of this laminar body. Now, a second case is that if this axis of rotation is perpendicular to the plane of this laminar body. Now a second case is for a laminar body when the axis of rotation is perpendicular to the plane of lamina, like this. Now let us again consider a plane lamina and let G be its center of mass and AB is an axis passing through this center of mass and also perpendicular to the plane of this lamina, and let IAB or IG be the moment of inertia about this AB axis. And now let us consider another axis CD parallel to this axis AB in a plane perpendicular to the plane of this lamina and at a distance h from this AB axis. Now we have to calculate the moment of inertia of this lamina about this CD axis that is passing through the lamina through a point O. Now for this, again let us consider the lamina to be divided into a large number of small particles of masses M1, M2, M3 and so on. From those all particles, let us consider a particle of mass M1 at a point P here. Now this point P is at a distance of x1 from this point O. We have considered this thing that this point P is at a distance x1 from point O. Also we can see here that this lamina is in the plane of the paper and these AB and CD axes are perpendicular to the plane of paper. Now we have here two right angle triangles. First is triangle OPQ and second is triangle GPQ. We will use these right angle triangles further in our article. Now, we have considered this particle of mass m1 at a point P and at a distance x1 from this point O, that is from this axis CD. Therefore, the moment of inertia of this particle m1 about this axis CD will be equal to the mass m1 of the particle into square of the distance from the axis, that is x1 square. That is, we will have the moment of inertia of the particle about CD axis equal to m1 x1 square. Therefore, if we consider the whole lamina, then the moment of inertia of this whole lamina about this CD axis, taking into reference this single particle, we can write the moment of inertia will be equal to ICD, or we can write it as IO, equal to m1 x1 square for the first particle plus m2 x2 square the second particle, and so on. We can write this thing as summation, the summation mx square. Now this x is equal to OP. Now therefore we can write it as summation m into OP square. In the same way, we can find out the moment of inertia of this mass m1 about AB axis, which is at a distance of GP or PG from this axis. Therefore, its moment of inertia about AB axis will be equal to m1 into GP square. Here it is, like this. And now, if we consider the whole lamina, then the moment of inertia of whole lamina about AB axis will be written as IAB, or is equal to IG, equal to summation m into PG square. Now, let us draw a perpendicular PQ on OG produced from P. That is, here we have this. Draw a perpendicular PQ on OG produced up to point Q. Now, here we have a triangle, in fact two triangles, triangle OPQ and triangle GPQ. Now, what is the significance of these triangles? Here, in this capital triangle, triangle OPQ, which is a right angle triangle at Q, we can write by using the Pythagoras theorem that x1 square is equal to OQ square plus PQ square. In the same way, in right angle triangle, triangle GPQ, we can write GP square is equal to GQ square plus PQ square. We will use these things later in the article. Now here we have OP square is equal to OQ square plus PQ square. Here it is, OP square is equal to OQ square plus PQ square. Now OQ is equal to OG plus GQ. We can write it here, OQ is equal to OG plus GQ whole square plus PQ square as it is. Opening this square, we get OG square plus GQ square plus 2 times OG into GQ plus PQ square. Now IO here is equal to summation m OP square. Using this value of OP square in this equation, we get IO is equal to summation m OG square plus GQ square plus 2 times OG plus GQ into GQ, sorry, plus PQ square. Now this GQ square plus PQ square, here in this figure, GQ square plus PQ square is equal to GP square according to Pythagoras theorem in this right angle triangle. We can write it here. Therefore, this GQ square plus PQ square is equal to GP square. Therefore, IO becomes summation M into OG square plus GP square plus 2 times OG into GQ. Opening the summation, we get summation m into OG square plus summation m into GP square plus 2 times summation m into OG into GQ. Now, this OG is equal to, here, OG is equal to H. Therefore, we can write it as summation m into H square. Also, this is summation m is the total mass of all the particles, which is equal to the mass of the lamina, that is capital M. Therefore, this term become equal to m H square plus summation m Gp square. Now, this is a IAB or IG. Therefore, we can write it here IG plus 2 times summation m OG into GQ. Now, OG is equal to H. Therefore, we can write it like this. H can be taken outside the summation because it is a constant term. Therefore, this term becomes 2H summation m into GQ. Now, again, since the body balances about the center of mass G, therefore, the algebraic sum of all the moments, all the particles about the axis passing through its center of mass G must be equal to zero. That is summation, that is the algebraic sum, summation of moments of all the particles, that is m into gq, must be equal to zero. Therefore, using this thing in this equation, we get io is equal to ig plus mh square from here. And this is also the theorem of parallel axis, hence the theorem proved. Thank you.